हेलो क्लास। वेलकम टू सेशन नंबर 40। मॉड्यूल नंबर 4, लिवरेज एनालिसिस। सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट इन फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट। How we can increase the shareholders' value with the help of the trading on equity concept that is considered as leverages. Leverages means actually by putting the minimum effort, how we can get the maximum results. So we have fundamental three leverages operating financial and combined, and we have specific formula for the calculation. So first we need to prepare or draw the income statement. Next, based on that income statement value, we are going for the calculation of the leverages. So theoretical part of the formulas and the statement is already discussed in the previous session, so kindly go through that. Now in this session we will compute problem, we will work out one problem with respect to the computation of the three leverages. So first we will go to the problem: compute operating leverage, financial leverage and combined leverage from the following information. Sales is given 2 lakh units at rupees 4 per unit selling price. So here we need to convert sales into volume because it is given in terms of units. So at any case, don't consider sales as 2 lakh. Sales is in the quota to units only. So now then no volume aagi convert madbeko. So 2 lakh should be multiplied by 4. Next, variable cost is 60% of sales. Andre namge illi omme sales sikkadre 60% of sales will be variable cost. Like that we need to calculate the variable cost. Next, the fixed operating cost is 1 lakh. So usually fixed cost will remain same irrespective of the changes in production or sales. And last one, interest charge, that is interest on debenture or interest on loan, that is 9000. Now with the help of the following information, the three leverages we need to calculate: operating, financial and combined. Now the first thing, we need to draft the income statement. Income statement navu madbekagutade yakandre operating leverage andre contribution upon operating profit andre EBIT anta naavu helteve. Financial leverage EBIT athava earnings before interest and tax upon EBT, earnings before tax anta helteve. Mate combined leverage andre operating leverage multiplied by combined leverage. So first we will draft the income statement based on this information. Just I will go to Excel sheet. Now first we will write income statement. So first we will write sales. So sales, I already mentioned in the problem, 2 lakh units given. So we need to multiply by 4. So the volume is 8 lakh. So amount in rupees we can mention here. Next, from sales, we need to subtract. So the income statement format you should know. First of all, income statement format yava rithi irthadandre sales inda start aagthadhe yavagalo, sales less variable cost, you will get contribution, contribution minus fixed cost, where you will get EBIT andre earnings before interest and tax. It is also called as operating profit minus interest on debt, interest on any kind of long term loan. So that will give you earnings before tax. After that, you can subtract tax or preference dividend if it is there, and ultimately you will get earnings available to the equity shareholders. So now we will deduct variable cost. Now variable cost is 60% of sales. So it is mentioned in the problem, 60% of sales. So what we need to do here, 60% hege tagolvantadu, 8 lakh multiplied by 60%. If you do that calculation, it will give you 4,80,000. 4,80,000. Andre 8 lakh multiplied by 0.6. So the answer is contribution. So answer is contribution. So illi subtract madidre aitu 8 lakh minus 4,80,000. So that will give you 3,20,000. Next, less fixed cost. So in the problem they mentioned fixed cost is 1 lakh. So the answer you will get, that is called as earnings before interest and tax, in abbreviation form it is also called as EBIT for your understanding. So EBIT will be contribution minus fixed cost. So till here I think the operational activity will take place. So sales minus variable cost, so contribution you will get, and next stage subtract the fixed cost given the problem, so you will get earnings before interest and tax, and it is also known as operating profit. So till here I think the concept is very clear. We will move further. Next stage, less interest charge. Interest charge. So interest they mentioned in the problem is 9,000. So the answer is earnings before tax. In abbreviation it is called as EBT. EBT. So EBT is equal to EBIT minus interest. So that is 2,11,000. Andre iga tax payment madokinta munche namma earnings 2,11,000. If tax is given in the problem, we can subtract the tax, so we will get earnings after tax. But here I think there is no information about the tax and all. So till here we can calculate. Now next is the calculation of, I think, the leverages. So calculation of leverages we will write. Calculation of leverages. So first one is operating leverage. Operating leverage. Now the formula for operating leverage is, so operating leverage mainly focus on the fixed cost. Means if there is some change in sales, what would be the proportionate change in operating profit? So that will be explained with the help of operating leverage. So that's why the formula for operating leverage is contribution upon EBIT. So contribution upon EBIT. So contribution we need to take. So it is mentioned here, I think contribution is 3,20,000 divided by earnings before interest and tax. So that will give you, I think the answer is actually 1.45. Here it will be written in a fraction. It's converted actually. So here I will write that value 1.45. If you divide 3,20,000 by 2,20,000, so the answer is 1.45. 1.45. Next one, so operating leverage is done. The second one is financial leverage. So financial leverage calculation will be done with the help of the ratio. So here ratio will be EBIT upon EBT. So financial leverage, the concept of financial leverage is, it will focus on the financial cost. Operating leverage focus on operational cost. Financial leverage focus on financial cost, especially interest on debenture, interest on loan, or interest on any kind of debt. And it will explain the percentage change in earnings on percentage change in EBIT. So the formula for the calculation already we explained, EBIT upon EBT. Now EBIT we need to take first. So the calculated EBIT is 2,20,000 upon divided by EBT. So that will give you actually 1.04. And the last one is total leverage, or it's also called as combined leverage. Now the formula for combined leverage is, two ways we can calculate the combined leverage. One is, it's like contribution, operating leverage multiplied by combined financial leverage. So yellow formula workout after that. Contribution upon EBT. So contribution upon EBT, we can have the formula.
So you have to change EBT. Adhe rithiyalli operating leverage multiplied by financial leverage also fine. So answer will be same in both the cases. So contribution is 2,20,000
here. Upon contribution is 3,20,000. 3,20,000 upon, we need to make that formula equation, is equal to contribution is 3,20,000. Contribution is 3,20,000 divided by EBT. So that will give you exactly 1.52. See. Another way of calculation of the calculation of command leverage is operating leverage multiplied by financial leverage. So answer will be same in both the case, is equal to 1.45 multiplied by 1.04. So that will give 1.5, that will be rounded off to 2. So this is the concept of calculation of the leverages. So once we'll go for the income statement, once we'll have a recap. So from the given information, first we need to prepare the income statement. Sales is a starting point. Now whenever sales is given in terms of units, be very careful. Don't take exactly given the problem 2 lakh. Or any other figure in terms of units, you need to multiply it by selling price. So remember this, you need to multiply it by selling price. So that is the first point. So once you get sales less variable cost, sometimes variable cost is given in terms of units, cost per unit like that. Sometimes it is given in terms of percentage. Anyway, here it is given as a percentage, 60% of sales you take, 4,80,000. Next, you will get contribution, sales minus variable cost, that is contribution, 3,20,000. Fixed cost is given in the problem, 1 lakh. So, the answer is earnings before interest and tax. That is popularly known as EBIT. Next. Less tax is given in the problem, 9,000. So ultimate answer is earnings before tax, that is 2,11,000. So based on this calculation, next we can go for the calculation of leverages. Now, operating leverage, the formula is, it will explain the relation between contribution upon EBIT. That is 1.45. So, the concept of operating leverage is actually, if there is 1% change in sales, there is nearly 14.5%, or 1% means here, 1.45% change in operating profit. So that is the explanation they are giving here. Next one, if there is 1% change in EBIT, 1.04% change in EBT. That is the interpretation of financial leverage. Next, combined leverage is, if there is 1% change in contribution or maybe the sales, there is 1.51% change in EBT. And then by using fixed cost and fixed financial cost, fixed cost and the fixed operating cost only, equally fixed cost and the financial prakara, financial fixed cost and the interest on loan or interest on debenture. So we can maximize the earnings. We can maximize the equity shareholders' earnings. So that is the concept of the leverage. So the problem we solved here. So revision is ultimately first prepare the income statement, next apply the formula and compute the leverages. Thank you.